there's been a lot of things that have been said, and quite frankly, just aren't accurate. I think it's important that the public understands that this has been a very open and transparent process. The rules have been followed, and there have been some assertions to the contrary, which are false. And I would like the township attorney to comment on that, if you would, please.
Sure. The last two meetings, folks have come up to the podium and have said that this board acted illegally, that the board didn't follow its own rules, that the board violated its own ordinance. I've learned over the years that you don't fight with members of the audience because it doesn't get you anywhere. Perhaps I should have stood up and told them they were wrong, because they were wrong. The ordinance is adopted by Huron Township is 2006-03, which is much different than the state statute. The state statute is, quite frankly, quite poorly written. It is a statute that if the board takes no action, then automatically, if it's a raise that's proposed, they get that raise. So it's very easy for a board, quite frankly, to vote themselves a raise because they don't have to vote. They just fail to do anything, and it automatically comes into play. That is not the case with our ordinance. We've talked and we've had citizens talk about the 30-day requirement in section 4 of the ordinance. And when you read the ordinance, if you read it, not even carefully, if you read it, it provides that the Compensation Commission, in the report, in the recommendation, has to include a provision that recommendation should come into effect within 30 days of the time it's filed with the township clerk. And that's fine, they did that. That was part of the recommendation, said that it would take place within 30 days. There is absolutely nothing in the ordinance that says the board has to do anything. In fact, in that same section, it says that the board may accept the recommendation, it may reject the recommendation, or it may accept or reject parts of the recommendation. Anyone that knows contracts or certainly the law knows that may is permissive. If it says shall, it's something that the board has to do by law. If it says may, it's permissive, the board can do it, cannot do it, can choose to do nothing. Quite frankly, under the ordinance, the board can take this up this evening. It could have taken it up last meeting, the meeting before. It could decide not to take up the matter at all. Under the ordinance, until the board affirmatively accepts that recommendation, nothing happens. There are no automatic raises for anyone. If they were proposing a reduction, which would violate state law, I guess they could, but if they did that, that would not take effect until this board, by 4 votes, does something. So quite frankly, by coming up here and saying that the board acted illegally, and then today I don't know what the proposed violations of the Open Meetings Act were, but that's silly if it's on this board as well. But quite frankly, this board's done nothing wrong. I take offense personally. I've been doing this for 28 years, and it's my job to make sure that the board doesn't act illegally. And quite frankly, if I thought you were doing something untoward, then it's my job to stand up and tell you not to do that, and I didn't do that. And I'm sorry that I didn't bring this up 2 meetings ago when the citizens came up and made that allegation. But that's the law. You can do this tonight. You don't have to. You don't have to do it at all. If you don't do it, then the proposed increases don't take effect. That's it.
Yeah, thank you. See, I'm just a small-time lawyer, so I appreciate when you big city lawyers clarify things.
Yeah, always South Kids.
That's great. Thanks, Kevin.